gateway to Oz.
Under the rainbow,
this is where it was.
Hollyhocks and red ripe tomatoes,
hand-churned homemade ice cream.
Let me tell you, Kansas is more than tornadoes.
It's the best part of Dorothy's dream.
Today, Around Kansas starts with a story about the Order of the Indian Wars, a group dedicated to the history of Indian warfare in the U.S. Next is Fay Tincher, a comedian from Topeka who acted in and directed movies made in the silent era. Then enjoy a poem, and we'll end with information about the many historical sites in Kansas. Closed captioning brought to you by Kansas Soybean Commission, the Soybean Checkoff, progress powered by Kansas farmers. This segment is brought to you by Brown Chevrolet Buick in Waumego, just a short drive down the yellow brick road. It's Wednesday morning again, and I'm Frank.
I'm Deb.
And this is Around Kansas. This is a show when we talk about what makes Kansas great, the people, the places, the things. And so anyway, that's about all I'm going to say in this, because she is going to do some shameless self-promotion here. So
shameless.
I'm going to...
Shameless. But it's all for the common good, Frank. Take, you got it. You got it.
I'll have a little nap.
It's all for the common good. I'm working on a project, and I have been for a long time, on Charles Curtis. And, you know, most school kids in Kansas know that he was the vice president, Native American. He was Kaw and Osage and maybe some Potawatomi. And we've been working on some documentary proposals on Charles Curtis. But I will have a short volume on him available just in time for Christmas. Christmas is just around
Imagine
the corner, folks.
That.
I know. So you can email me, and we'll have my email there on the screen. And the pre-publication price for only $10 and $3 shipping and handling, you can have this under your tree just in time for Christmas. Our Charlie. From the reservation to Washington, so it's his Kansas years.
Mm-hmm. But wait, order now. And
order now, right. I'm not going to double it, though. Yeah. I feel like there used to be this show on Bonnie Lou and Buster when I was a kid, and they came from Wheeling, West Virginia, and they sold Jim Walter homes. Yes, friends, you too can own a Jim Walter home. They were hilarious. They do bluegrass, and she wore her... big fluffy skirt, you know, with the crinolines and everything. And yeah, Bonnie Lou and Buster. Here we are. Bonnie Lou and Buster. Don't you have something to sell this morning, Frank?
Well, let's see. Well, yes, I can always promote, of course, Wren Radio. Oldies Radio worldwide. You know, WrenRadio.net is where you can listen to us. Or
so
on TuneIn Radio, which is a free download from your app store.
Free is good. Free is good.
Free
How
is
much
good.
Is free?
Free is free. Yeah.
Free is free.
No, if you like oldies from the 50s, 60s, and early 70s, we've recreated an 88-year-old radio station, WREN, and you know, we now have like 200,000 listeners worldwide, so I think we're doing okay.
So Frank is free, I'm cheap. That's that's the bottom line this morning.
Oh
yeah,
my.
I've got low rates, but Frank is free over here. Of course, if you want to advertise with Wren, that's another great, especially with so many people doing business over the internet. That's a great opportunity, too.
Another thing, at least through the holidays, we've got, again, Beatles memorabilia on our wall in our studio over in Noto. It was very popular a year ago. It was going to be like a one-month deal, and it turned into 4 months that it was there. But one of the Beatles collectors is back, and it's on the wall. And so stop in anytime and take a look at this memorabilia.
Oh, that's a great, it's really cool. If you go to Noto, do your Christmas shopping, that's right. Then you stop in Wren and see the Beatle memorabilia. We'll be right back.
Lecompton, the name was splashed across newspapers throughout America and Europe. It was debated in the halls of Congress. Lecompton interprets its unique territorial history with two museums and other sites. Events throughout the year celebrate history and community. Visit the Territorial Capital Museum, where more than 70 trees are displayed with thousands of antique and vintage ornaments, and be sure to stop in the gift shops in both Lecompton museums. Spend the day in historic Lecompton, shopping, eating, savoring the rich history.
Buying a car shouldn't be this hard. And at Brown Chevrolet Buick in Wamego, it isn't. It's actually awesome. Whether you want a new or used car or truck, Toby's team can make the deal. Even if you want to custom order a new car or truck, Toby's team can make the deal. See Toby's team at Brown Chevrolet Buick in Wamego. We're awesome. Valley Vet Supply is devoted to providing information and professional quality products at reasonable prices.
ValleyVet.com, ValleyVet.com,
Valley Vet Supply.
This segment brought to you by Kansas Regenerative Medicine. Your stem cells, your health, your life.
And we're back, and I think we're done with all of our shameless self-promotion this morning.
No, now we're going to shamelessly promote other people.
Yeah.
And one of the things that we're going to be talking about for the next few weeks as we lead up to Christmas are Christmas gift ideas. And, you know, people have so much stuff. So it's always a challenge to figure out what to get, especially for guys. Guys are so hard to buy for. I don't know why, but they're so hard to buy for. And I belong to a lot of really interesting organizations that give you a lot of opportunities to do cool stuff. So one of those I want to talk about today is the Order of the Indian Wars. And it sounds like it's all about fighting, and there is a lot of that. There's a lot of military history in it. But we get to go on some really cool trips. So this past fall, we were in New Mexico, down around Las Cruces, and did some great day trips with some experts on the Apache Wars, and on Pancho Villa, and on Billy the Kid. So it's a really awesome organization. And then every spring they have an event in Denver that's just a day of talks and just camaraderie. But it brings together people from all over the country with a common interest, and it has some great opportunities. And so I just want to share a little bit of what they do with you guys today.
Okay.
There's a real joy in the company of folks who share the same passions and obsessions as yourself. That camaraderie is the glue that holds together the Order of the Indian Wars. Leighton Hooper, OIW board member, offered his insights. Leighton grew up in Smith Center, Kansas in the 1950s and 60s. While he was surrounded by countryside that was rife with Indian Wars history, it was the television that sparked his imagination. "My friends and I spent our summer days and weekends playing cowboys and Indians," said Leighton. "It's how we grew up, so naturally we still have love for Western and Indian Wars history." Leighton became fast friends with Indian Wars scholar and author Greg Micno after Leighton contacted him about one of his books. Then, living in Fort Collins, Leighton also became acquainted with Mike Corey, the organization's president. "We all belong to the Fort Collins Westerners," said Leighton. "Then I became a member of OIW. I became interested in Indian Wars history and the Apaches when I worked in Cochise Stronghold," added Leighton, "as a young man, as a firefighter for the Forest Service." The OIW was founded to study in depth and share U.S. military history of Indian warfare, whether it was tribes against one another or with immigrant peoples. To that end, the OIW holds two annual events, a symposium in Denver each spring and a trip in the fall. "We also seek to preserve and protect those important sites associated with this history," said President Mike Corey, "and to encourage people to become involved in preservation in their own communities." In 2015, the fall excursion explored points in southern New Mexico related to warfare with the Apache, events with Pancho Villa, and the life of Billy the Kid. Next year, the group heads east to western Pennsylvania to explore sites related to a young George Washington and the French and Indian Wars. Whether it's Geronimo, Sand Creek, Little Bighorn, or lesser-known sites or personalities, the OIW jumps headfirst into discovery. The journey is enlightening, respectful, always surprising. The best part, though, is the company you have along the way. For more information, visit IndianWars.com.
Here's another gardening tip with Annette Jackson from Jackson's Greenhouse.
Fall is a great time to plant perennials, trees, shrubs, and bulbs. Root development occurs with the moist and cool soil conditions, which means better growth next year with less watering and maintenance. The use of mulch on all plantings helps protect from freezing, thawing, and drying out. Let Jackson's help with your next planting.
Jackson's top quality fall bulbs for spring blooming have arrived. Always plant the best bulbs for bigger, better blooms.
Jackson's Greenhouse has what you need today.
Next time you see a beautiful field of corn, reach out and thank the farmers who work tirelessly to raise corn for livestock feed, renewable fuels, and exports to feed a growing world population. The farmers on the Kansas Corn Commission work for Kansas corn with grower-funded checkoff dollars that support foreign and domestic market development, research, promotion, and education to expand opportunities for Kansas farmers. To learn more, visit kscorn.com.
Around Kansas, brought to you by Santa Fe Trail Meats in Overbrook, or visit us online at sftmeats.com.
And we're back again. You know, we've talked about a lot of people in show business in one form or another, either Broadway star or TV soap star, something like that. And there are a lot of them from Kansas. There really are, and a lot of them from Topeka. And I recently discovered another one named Fay Tincher. Now, and I don't know, you know there are Coca-Cola trays, and a lot of them are now repops. Thing is Fay is on one of those.
Isn't that
And
something?
I have seen one of them over in Noto at Finders Keepers. He has a lot of Coca-Cola memorabilia. I've got to go back over there now and see if he still has that one. But Fay Tincher was a model. And she was an actress in silent movies. And anyway, a very interesting story about Fay. And she,
beautiful gal.
Yeah, lived a very, very long life. And so anyway, I'm going to share that with you.
The lively, dark-haired comedienne was often called the female Charlie Chaplin, appearing in more than 160 films between 1913 and 1930, the silent era. Fay Tincher was not the typical actress or beauty queen, though she was both. In fact, she wasn't typical at all. A film historian noted that most of her films from this period are lost. We know little of those years when Tincher was at her most powerful as a film producer as well as a comedy star. In front of the camera, Fay Tincher had three distinct personae: Ethel, the stenographer, the role that made her a star; a cowgirl; and a housewife, Min Gump. Before taking the role of Min, her characters were consistently strong, independent women, anticipating something of the uniqueness, confidence, and even dominance of men, with the chutzpah later embodied by Mae West. Like West, Tincher was short, only 5'2", but both commanded the screen despite their size. Unlike West, however, Tincher never pretended to be a sex symbol. She rarely put herself in a romantic situation and rejected conventional beauty. The Milwaukee Journal in 1914 observed that Tincher persists and reveals in making herself look awkward, no makeup, nor does she care how it makes her look, provided it accomplishes her purpose, to make people laugh and be happy. Fay was born to a wealthy Topeka family in 1884. She began appearing in amateur theater at an early age, and from the beginning she was remarkably savvy about publicity and gained a good deal of notoriety in 1908 when she seemed to be unsure about whether or not she had, or on a dare, married a wealthy Connecticut bachelor named Ned Buckley. Stories about this escapade ran in a number of papers, including The World, where a 1908 Tincher is quoted as saying, "Not that Ned would not make a desirable husband for any girl who wished to marry, but I do not want to marry him nor any man."
As far as is known, however, this marriage was a publicity hoax. Tincher never did marry and did not have children. Fay Tincher seems to have struck out on her own when she formed Fay Tincher Productions in 1917, but exactly how many comedies she made is uncertain, and none of these seem to have survived. She seemingly disappeared after her final film appearance in 1930, as talking films changed the industry. Her image is immortalized on a Coca-Cola tray. Many of the headlines mentioning Fay during the height of her career were in the social columns. A sister, Elizabeth, committed suicide following the accidental shooting death of her husband. Another was married to a Topeka mayor. Fay died of a heart attack at the age of 99 and is buried on Staten Island in an unmarked grave.
Biodiesel made from sustainable resources is diversifying our fuel supply. This year, biodiesel will displace over 1 billion gallons of fossil fuel nationwide. It's making our economy stronger and our communities healthier. It's working here and across America. Get biodiesel going in your community. Visit americasadvancedbiofuel.com.
Soil is the life of a farm, and for 25 years, SureCrop Liquid Crop Nutrition has helped growers produce abundant quality crops while preserving and improving the soils they steward. SureCrop offers complete soil and plant analysis with cropping recommendations, delivery direct to your on-farm storage, and quality crop nutrition custom blended for your field. Choose SureCrop for the assurance of excellence for your soil. Call today or visit their website for more information.
The Kansas Wheat Innovation Center in Manhattan is rediscovering ways to get improved varieties and new genetics in the hands of farmers faster. Grower-led and Checkoff-funded research initiatives are bringing about positive change. This grassroots leadership provides a strong voice in Topeka and Washington, D.C. Now is the time to partner with Kansas Wheat in moving wheat forward. Kansas Wheat Commission and Kansas Association of Wheat Growers. Farmers investing in their future and yours. Log on to rediscoverwheat.org.
Tallgrass Commodities offers producers bulk commodities at a reasonable price with reliable service throughout the whole Midwest. To find out more about Tallgrass Commodities, visit tallgrass.us or call 785-494-8484.
This segment is brought to you by the Kansas Soybean Commission, the Soybean Checkoff, progress powered by Kansas farmers.
Years ago, we had a bad fire here at the ranch when our daughter was little. We lost an entire machine shed, and it was a traumatic experience for her. I wrote this poem about that day. It's titled, You Have to Cowboy Up. Daddy, what do we do? My little girl said as we stared at the burning remains of our shed. The machine shed on our ranch had just gone up in flames with the tractors and trailers and wagons it contained. I looked at my daughter as she cradled her scared pup and said, at times like these, you have to cowboy up. You have to be strong. You have to be tough. You can't let hard times get you down facing this stuff. When you get bucked off, pick yourself up off the ground and get back on that horse to try another round. And if life gives you lemons, you just can't be afraid. Turn a negative into a positive and make some lemonade. Yes, we've lost our old machine shed, but that opens up some space. We'll be able to rebuild something better in its place. But Daddy, my daughter said with tear-filled eyes, think of all the work you did on those things inside. Yes, I said as I thought of what we faced. It is a loss, and there are things that just can't be replaced. But things are still just things. They're not the people that we love. We still have many blessings, thanks to the good Lord up above. So I held my daughter close as I drained my coffee cup and said, be brave, my little one. You have to cowboy up. Happy trails.
I'm a patient of Kansas Regenerative Medicine in Manhattan. I had stem cell therapy in my hips and my left knee. My wife and I both are patients. We went down there the same day in November. Since then, my hips are feeling a lot better. I can work now most of the day if I want to. And before, if I worked in the morning, I was done in the afternoon. Or if I worked in the afternoon, I was sure enough done for the rest of the day.
Heinen Brothers, a fourth-generation Northeast Kansas farm family, knows how tough farming can be. Farmers helping farmers. Heinen Brothers Ag, selling and servicing crop protection products, fertilizer, anhydrous ammonia, cover crops, quality aerial and ground application. Call today to learn about our extended term financing program, 800-760-4964. HeinenBrothersAg.com.
Kansas Farm Bureau, the voice of agriculture, represents grassroots agriculture. The state's largest and most powerful farm organization stands up for its members through leadership development, agriculture education, legal defense, environmental advocacy, farm safety, and risk management. Members also enjoy money-saving benefits. To join our organization today or to learn more, go to www.kfb.org or find us on Facebook and Twitter.
To see this show and past episodes of Ag AM in Kansas, go online to agamandkansas.com.
Around Kansas, brought to you by
Kansas Farm Bureau, the voice of agriculture. Go to kfb.org or find us on Facebook and Twitter.
Welcome back. And Frank and I are always encouraging you to get out and see the state. And there's so much to see and do, of course. And again, following up on the theme of what to get people for Christmas, there are memberships available at the Friends groups that support a lot of our state and national historic sites. But there's a few in particular I wanted to share with you today. And the Parks and Tourism asked me to write a blog for them. They wanted me to name my 10 favorite sites, and I thought, well, that's a way to make enemies, you know, win friends and influence people. So what I did was preface what I wrote about by saying if it's a state site or if it's a national site, it's so designated for a good reason. And those are places that you just ought to see, period. So, you know, one of my favorite state sites is the Pawnee Indian site in Republic County, because it's on an actual site of an Indian village. It's so unique. It's one that's sort of off the beaten path, so a lot of people don't pass it every day. You know, you have to sort of be on your way to get there, but that's one, everybody's got to see that one at some point. So let's take a look at a few others. The story of Kansas is interpreted through dozens of historic sites around the state. Each tells one piece of the story, whether it is westward expansion, the struggle for statehood, or the rich and varied cultures that have called Kansas home. There are four National Park Service sites, Fort Scott and Larned, Brown v. Board, and Nicodemus. In addition, the Tall Grass Prairie Natural Preserve celebrates the grassland ecosystem of the Great Plains. Five nationally recognized trails cross Kansas: the Santa Fe, with more miles in Kansas than any other state; the Pony Express; the Oregon; the California; and Lewis and Clark. Signage and sites along the way, in addition to pre-recorded audio tours, are available for the explorer. The Kansas State Historical Society administers several sites, including its museum and the newly restored State House. They are Constitution Hall in Lecompton, Fort Hays, Grinter Place, Hollenberg Station, Kaw Mission, Shawnee Indian Mission, Pawnee Indian Museum, Red Rocks, home of William Allen White, and Mine Creek Battlefield. Self-guided sites are Iowa and Sac and Fox Mission, Pawnee Rocks, and Merdazine Massacre Site. Partner sites are Cottonwood Ranch, the First Territorial Capital, Goodnow House, and the John Brown Museum. Merely listing these names gives you an idea of the variety of eras and stories represented at each of these places. Many of them have friends organizations and gift shops. Support those with your dollars. Take the kids. Take the grandkids. Pick up a National Park Service passport and encourage your family to begin collecting the stamps from across the nation. Kansas first. Often, we plan trips to experience something new when we haven't even experienced what we have here at home. Click your heels and repeat. There's no better history than in Kansas. There's no better history than in Kansas. There's no better history than in Kansas.
Gee, we're out of time again. So, I'm Frank.
I'm still Deb.
And we'll see you somewhere around Kansas.
Welcome to Kansas, gateway to Oz.
Under the closed rain, captioning brought to you by Kansas Soybean Commission. Holly, the Soybean Checkoff, progress tomato, powered by Kansas farmers.
Hand-churned homemade ice cream. Let me tell you, Kansas is more than tornadoes. We're the best part of Dorothy's dream. We're the best part of Dorothy's dream.
To see this show and past episodes of Ag AM in Kansas, go online to agamandkansas.com.